really great way of just organizing the information you need with more structure than exists in Obsidian. You can add it to the easel. Now I have the note, the capture in here, and it has the original link. That is so helpful. Tell me more about details of this concept, which is fantastic when you're learning to have a little bit of direction. Let's get the obvious one out of the way. I love Obsidian. I still use Obsidian. I mean, every single day I'm in here trying to work on my thinking. It's the place for my second brain. I use it to take Zettelkasten notes. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you can check out this video here. I go in so much more depth. If you feel like there's a lot going on in your head, you're not going deeper with any of those ideas, you keep on forgetting ideas, but then they come back and you're like, oh, right, well, I need to write it down. And then you have pieces of paper everywhere like me. Then you gotta try smart note-taking. You can check out this video here. But before you go, I want to point out one way I use Obsidian, which is not common, that I don't manage any tasks in here. I've tried using calendars, using Kanban boards in here, but they actually became distractions for me. Every time I'm in Obsidian, I want to focus on my ideas. I don't want to be thinking about, here's a small task I need to do. I don't want to distract myself with that. So I actually use a different app. Let me show you what it is. This is where I manage the other half of my brain that needs to deal with deadlines, manage projects, tasks, work with freelancers, and run the business. Everything happens in xTiles. And they're also today's sponsor. Thank you for supporting the channel. You know, I don't take on that many sponsorships because I don't use that many apps. So it's great to be able to support it for the ones that you do use. All right, I got to this system because I used to just use pen and paper for my daily planning. It was so satisfying to do pen on paper, but things fell through the cracks because it's just not dynamic enough. And so I wanted a digital complement, and everyone was saying, oh, try Notion, use Notion, it's great. It's too powerful for me. I spent way too much time setting things up, beautifying everything, trying to find the perfect template, trying to learn how things worked. And also there's a small crack in my personality where I don't want to use the things that everyone else is using. So I ended up choosing this system, and it's a three-part system. Let me show you how I've set it up. First of all, I have a home page. And this doesn't look like other people's one. It doesn't have a lot of things on it. And that's intentional because I realize it's almost like a meditation moment for me when I start to sit down and I'm ready to work. I need to brain dump everything that's in my mind that I'm thinking of, like tasks, the things I need to remember. I need to get all of that out of the way before I can actually focus. And so this is designed like this. First of all, here is a photo of my puppy, Pico. Hello. So I think this is my first time showing him to the world. But yeah, so I try to mimic my desk setup for this page. So, you know, I'll have a photo that's kind of like the photo on the wall. I have a navigation bar. If you use Notion, you know, it links to the different pages. I have this month's focus. Again, it's kind of like a post-it on the wall that reminds me, hey, here are your North Stars. For me, it's the 5-minute communication framework course launch. It is to finish the book that I'm reading, and it's to be consistent with the gym. And you see, I mix work and personal because otherwise personal just fades into the background. So I'm not gonna let that happen. And then I have my workspace. So here is only two things that I'm working on, which is quick tasks that I want to write down and project notes that I have in my mind. Because I find I can't focus if I'm thinking about, oh, don't forget about this, don't forget about that. So I try to list them all out. I don't add anything else, but I do know other people like habit trackers and all of that. If you can focus, you can just simply add by dragging and dropping. It's pretty intuitive. You can add cool images. You can add text notes. You can use slash as a command, and you can all add all sorts of things like a table, all that good stuff. So intuitive, I'm sure you've seen it in other software as well. Now, one thing I really love is you can move text from one place to another. So for me, once I have my tasks created, I usually move them to a dedicated page where I keep track of all my quick tasks. So tomorrow I can put in new tasks and I don't lose them. So I do these during my spare time. You can add, you know, deadlines on these things. You can add reminders. Pretty intuitive. It is really helpful for me to just know everything has been captured. And then for the more complicated one, I use a database. I'm sure you've seen this with Notion, with other platforms or software. You can add priorities, sort things. You can see things in calendar view. You can sort things by done, not done, all very intuitive. Then for project management, I also use a content calendar like this. So again, same thing, database, you can see it by Kanban board. There are a few things that really work for me. Number one, you can simply share the link with anyone and they'll be able to see these things. So whenever I work with freelancers, for example, I've been working on my website, I have this page on Vibe of what I'm trying to get across. I just need to copy the link, send them the link, and they'll be able to see these. So easy for collaboration. Can't do that with Obsidian without paying. Also, you can do documents as well as these kinds of whiteboards. So for example, I would put some of my scripts here so I can turn them into other forms of content. Again, very easy to use. You can format all of those good stuff. I also do some of my brainstorming here. For example, I have a specific group called Course where I'm trying to figure out the cadence of when to launch what. Again, helpful to do the brainstorming in a database and then be able to see them in calendar view, and you can drag them around to make sure everything makes sense. You can look at board by status. So really great way of just organizing the information you need with more structure than exists in Obsidian. And xTiles comes with a few built-in things that make organizing your life so much easier. For example, you have the taskbar that will list all of your tasks across the different pages so you don't have to manually try to bring them all together. You have the calendar view that you can take a look right away. You can integrate your calendar as well. And whenever you're lost, you can just discover all the templates. So if you're a templates kind of person, it will give you the things that others have already created. I've also got my templates. So if you think similarly as me, then you can use them down below. Try out xTiles for free. And for those who want to upgrade, I also negotiated us a 25% off exclusive discount. So use those in the link down below and let's get to the next software. The next one you've actually been seeing already, and that is Arc. This is the browser. It is making browsing the internet more fun for me. I didn't think this was possible, but I think they do it, number one, because of their functionality, and number two, because of their design. Like, just looking at this makes me so happy, and it makes me want to make my website better, make my channel better, make my branding better. I actually always look forward to their feature updates because they're always very fun and easy to read. A great example of visual thinking. But anyway, the functions, there are three things I want to talk about. First, they have a space for personal browser and then another one for work. This way you can really separate the tabs and not get overwhelmed by them. The next thing, which is small but really fun to tweak with, is the boost function. So I talked about, you know, not being able to help myself but want to beautify things, and Arc makes it really easy. So even if, let's say, xStyle only has this font, by using Arc, I can just choose different fonts. I love the monospace. You can change colors of everything if you like. Like, this retro look is great. It reminds me of New Jeans. You can change the size very easily. You can change the case. I find no caps to be very easy to read. Like, this is amazing. You can do it in 1 second. I know for some people, this is nice to have. So let me talk about two must-have functions that I cannot live without. They're both in the plus sign down here. First one is easel. So this is Arc's whiteboard note-taking by itself. Nothing too special. Let's say I'm taking notes on the book I'm reading. You know, you can add text. You can add arrows. You can add, you know, shapes. You can draw stuff. Nothing special. But when you add it with a new split screen, already you can see it's so much easier to take notes. Let's say I am looking for some book reviews and I come here. I can already, let's say, oh, the Epimenides. Is that right? Paradox. I need to take some notes on that. Great. But this is not all. You can also capture. Again, the capture functionality is not unique, but let me show you. As you capture, you can edit it. Say, I want to make a note on this. It looks so good. Let's say, oh, actually, I want to circle this. It's easy. And when you do that, you can send this via iMessage. You can save it. You can copy it. And you can add it to the easel. So let me do that. Now I have the note, the capture in here. I can resize it, move it, and it has the original link. That is so helpful. Something I can't quite do without laboring over things in Obsidian with Canvas. And then the cool thing is, as you build the notes, you can also share the easel. So not only are you able to share the captures that you've done, if you've got a bunch of them, you can organize it and share it to other people. Anyone can view, anyone can edit, and this way, really, I find if I need to share the information anyway, I can do that easily in Obsidian. This is my go-to. Plus, there's actually the next tool I wanted to show you that works so well with this, which is Albus. This is an AI learning tool. Let me just log in and show you. First of all, I love the aesthetic and it is so helpful. So it runs on ChatGPT. You get unlimited use with ChatGPT, Gemini, and Haiku. And what happens is you can use this as a normal whiteboard. You know, you can add notes, you can add text, but I like to use it to ask things. For example, one of the paradox here, let me ask, what is the Epimenides paradox? I am not saying this right. Someone help me. All right. And what it'll do is generate an answer. Okay, it's named after someone. Great, it's starting to generate the answer. And you might say, well, can't I do that with ChatGPT? Absolutely, you can. But what is really cool is you can do that and do breakdowns of the topic. Let's see, we want the paradox to be the topic. What happens is it will break down this concept for you. So it talks about the self-referential statements, it talks about liar paradox, truth and falsity, and if you click on one of them, say infinite loop, it will start to generate an answer. Again, by itself, maybe not that interesting, but what you can do is you can tell me more about details of this concept, which is fantastic when you're learning to have a little bit of direction. That's one thing. The other thing is you can ask it another question. For example, then you can really have a conversation with Albus and put more context to your learning. It's like having a tutor for yourself. And then say, this is way too wordy. What you can do is, okay, let me listen to the audio narration. Maybe I want to download it. Maybe I want to actually have it summarize, so I don't need to read the entire thing. I mean, there's so much you can do with this, especially because I'm trying to learn philosophy, ideas that I don't have a lot of context around, it's helpful to have these pointers. Another really cool feature they have is you can toggle music on and off. You can export the whole board as you're learning. So what I do is then I use this as a source to start getting some ideas of how can I even break down concepts like this. How exciting is this? There are so many tools that we can use to augment the way that we think, the way that we communicate, the way that we learn. I mean, these are my favorite ones. Let me know which ones you like down in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.